Welcome to Getting Real here on Fullerton College Television. I'm Brandon Leva, your host, and here to talk about her college experience at Cal State Fullerton is Ari Johnson. Thank you for joining us today.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Right
Super
on.
Super excited.
So tell us, why did you decide to go to attend Cal State Fullerton?
So when I went to high school, no one really knew what Cal State Fullerton was. I went to high school in Elk Grove in Sacramento, Northern California, super far. So yeah. No one really knew what it was, and I had a friend that actually went to Cal State Fullerton, mm-hmm. and she showed me around. And honestly, there's like this line, two lines of palm trees that overlook the arts building,
yeah.
and I just thought it was really pretty. And so that's honestly why I was like, okay, yeah, I think I'll go here. Plus, it was far enough away from Sacramento that mm-hmm. I didn't have to go home every weekend, and yeah. I could just fly a quick hour flight home, and it was nice.
Right on.
It's cool.
Would you say the feeling of wanting some independence is what drove you to pick helping your choice?
Yeah, I think so. I was pretty independent, like at home, but living on my own is definitely a challenge. But mm-hmm. I like having my own independence, so it's always weird going back home.
Right on. So, what is your major that you were pursuing?
So I started off as a business major a long time ago, and I actually switched to communications with an emphasis in public relations, mm-hmm. and I have a minor in poli-sci, which used to be a double major, but trying to graduate.
Yeah. So why did you choose to pursue telecommunications?
Not telecommunications,
but
communications, and my emphasis is in PR.
PR.
And so I like to talk, obviously,
yeah.
and I have a big personality, so everyone is always like, you should do something that like involves people and like join comm, like mm-hmm. you can do like TV or PR or journalism. I actually wanted to do journalism. And then I switched to PR just because I like yeah. people, like human interactions,
yeah.
like talking a lot.
You like socializing.
Yeah, I like socializing.
Connections.
Networking, yeah.
Right on.
Good
so,
people person.
Yeah. So what in particular would you like to do with being?
So I want to do like, you know, like YouTube makeup artists, how they go on like these really cool influencer trips,
yeah.
like to like Bora Bora or like Turks and Caicos.
Mm-hmm.
I want to be the person that plans the trips and picks all the stuff that the influencers get and pick the influencers and that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Just because I think it'd be really cool to travel and work in that element of PR, and I love makeup, so
right
it'd be pretty cool.
So on more of the school side of things, what would you say would be the most difficult thing about trying to stay on track at a four-year university?
I think just because when you go to college, you're a fresh, young baby, and
yeah.
so you don't really know what you want to do. Yeah, you're not really, freshman year, you're not really
yeah.
like into school that much. You're
yeah.
just taking GEs, you know, you just want to experience college. And so staying on track with like knowing how many units to take and what classes to take first was really hard. Like I just took GEs and I didn't take enough GEs.
Yeah.
And so I'm having to take summer classes and intersession classes just to finish in four. So I would have liked like talking to a counselor, some guidance throughout
right on.
My first years.
Cool, cool. Anything helpful resources at school that helped you kind of get back on track or keep on track?
I think like when I started to get really serious about school, like junior, senior year,
mm-hmm.
I started going to academic advising, the Career Center, the library. At least mm-hmm. I live at the library now. And just advising for sure, because you don't really know what you're doing when you're trying to pick your
yeah.
classes by yourself. You don't know, like, oh, if you're actually on track to graduate. I didn't
mm-hmm.
know. Starting out this year, I didn't think I was going to graduate this year. And when I went to advising, they were like, oh, no, it's possible. You can walk this year. And I was like,
yeah.
I was really excited. So.
Right on.
You can't do it without advising. So.
True. Very true. So we're going to be going to commercial in a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to leave you off with a question to think about it. If there were any classes that were influential on you.
Okay. One
yeah. yeah in particular, and mm-hmm. then when we come back, we would like to see you really expand on it.
Okay.
And tell us all about it. So we'll be right back from this commercial break. Afterwards, when we come back, Ari will tell us more about the classes that really influenced her. See you in a bit. back to the show, party people. I'm Brandon Laver, your host, and we are joined with Ari. And when we last left off, I asked her which classes have been the most influential on you.
Okay, so I'll talk about two. The first one super briefly. I took Communications 233, which is communications in the mass media. Mm-hmm. So it's all about learning about your audience. And so we had one of our projects was to do a blog, which yeah. I loved. So I had a blog for about, I did it for the class, and then I actually ended up doing it for like a year afterwards, which is super fun. Kind of got me into the calm world of like being interactive and mm-hmm. building my network. And then Communications 361 was the Intro to Public Relations. That class I loved. It taught me everything about PR. Yeah. It made me pick my emphasis in PR mm-hmm. From that class. And I had a really big project that really, really helped me to get to where I am now in the field. So I really liked that class.
Right. Anything in particular that class like really moved you to pursue PR?
Yeah, I actually got a job from the class. We did, our big project was to interview or shadow someone in the PR field. Mm-hmm. It was kind of like what you put in was what you got out of it. So like some people just like interviewed someone from a nonprofit or just helped out an event. But I emailed like 25 different PR agencies mm-hmm. I was like, hi, I'm a student, Cal State Fullerton, like, can I please shadow you for a class? Like, please, 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 please. And I think like five people responded back. And so I chose to shadow at the ACE agency in Santa Ana.
Cool.
And they asked if I would help on their event at the Queen Mary. It was a magic show type of thing, which is super cool.
Yeah.
And it was my first like stepping stone mm-hmm. into the PR world. And so it was really great. I ended up getting my internship for my spring semester mm-hmm. from the agency, and also I freelance for them as well.
Right
so
on.
It's super awesome.
Cool. Could you tell us about that day at the Queen Mary?
And so I did like a pre-event like a couple of days before, and so I went to the Queen Mary, and they were doing like a nighttime, mm-hmm. Like a TV remote shooting thing for KTLA, which was super cool because I'd never like really been behind the scenes, so mm-hmm. super cool. They did a filming of a couple of magic acts that were going to be at the event, as well as like a cool liquid nitrogen ice cream man
because
all of the smoke and stuff.
Yeah.
So it was magical, and I got to be an extra, which is cool. I was like, hi, Mom, in the back. And so I did that, and then the day of the event, I did the media and celeb check-in, and so mm-hmm. all of the media outlets that were there, given wristbands, checked them in, let them know everything about the event, which was super cool. And it was like my first like real interaction with media and PR, and which was cool. And I got a lot of advice from the other girl I was working with. She actually was a Cal State Fullerton alum.
Oh, wow.
And so she had like taken all the same classes. And so she told me like, oh, you can do an internship here, and like you can take this class and this class. And so I was like, oh my gosh,
thank you
so much. Yeah, she helped a lot. And so she kind of made me realize like I should probably like get on track with school and like advising and all that stuff.
Right on. So what responsibilities do you have as a freelancer for them and in your internship, and what are you most excited for?
I'm excited to start my internship because mm-hmm. right now I do just on-site event staff for them.
Yeah.
So they do all of the PR for the Queen Mary. So anytime Queen Mary has a big event, like mm-hmm. they just did Dark Harbor, it's a really big Halloween maze. And so different media outlets and celebrities wanted to go and attend the event. And so I would take them around for media, like for taping, like I would take them around to the cool mazes that had like mm-hmm. cool visuals, got them all around so they would get like the best footage possible. For the celebs, it was kind of a little bit more fun. I got to hang out with some really cool celebs that I liked, like Kendall Jenner, Vanessa and Stella Hudgens. I died on the inside. They all hugged me too, so I was like freaking out, but like super professional at the time. But it was so exciting. And so I get to take them around. It's super hands-on, and so I'm learning a lot of experience and like meeting some really cool people in the industry, and they're like, oh, keep in contact with me. So I'm like, yes, I will.
Right on.
Yeah, it's really cool. And so I kind of just do the media coordinating for them. And then in the office, which I'm excited for, I'll be doing more like media lists and working on how to organize all of that instead of doing on staff. So
cool.
It's kind of a mix of both, so it's cool.
All right, cool. Well, I appreciate you for coming. I love your stories.
Thank you.
And whatnot. So, hope you guys enjoyed Ari telling us about herself, and I hope it inspires you. See you guys later. Peace.